All right, it is time for me to go to another Grand Prix. San Diego was last week, but now I am headed over to Detroit, the wonderful city of Detroit. I've actually never been there, but heading over to Detroit, Grand Prix Detroit for Team Limited with the format's going to be Origins Team Sealed. So it's going to be, what that means is I'm going to be opening 12 boosters of Origins with teammates Tom Martel and Alex Hain. And, you know, this is the first time that all three of us are teaming together, and it should be fun. So, you know, a lot of you guys are going to ask, like, well, what happened to the Porpoise North? Why are we not playing together in this tournament? Well, just quick story. Basically, you know, the main motivation, or the, one of the main reasons why LSV and Ifro teamed with me last year, you know, despite me just not being on my A game, I haven't played for a while, was the fact that, you know, they thought it would be really, really cool if they could help qualify me for the Pro Tour. And they did, you know. I think a third of my pro points last year came from Team Grand Prix. And, you know, now I'm on the train. So, you know, for team tournaments, it's always fun, but it's always cool to see what it would be like to team with other good Magic players. So, you know, Fro and Ben are good friends. They're both very, very good at Magic and very good Limited Minds. And Fro has always wanted to team with Ben, but has never had the opportunity to team with him because Ben's always had his own team. And now they had this opportunity. I'm on the train. So for this Grand Prix, it's not a permanent thing. For this Grand Prix, Ifro, Luis, and Ben are going to be teaming up. That's definitely a team to watch out for. So as soon as I got that, as soon as, you know, we talked about it, I knew that I needed to find good teammates that I knew I'd have a lot of fun playing with. So immediately the names, you know, I had a handful of names that came to mind, went on Facebook and was like, all right, Alex, Tom, let's do this. Let's play, let's team up. And yeah, now it's a thing. So I'm gonna be heading out tomorrow. I've been doing a lot of drafts since I got back from the Grand Prix. So I feel pretty good about the format. I just, you know, just, it's hard to practice Team Sealed, but I just know, you know, like I have the proper mindset for Origins Limited. I mean, we've already been testing for the Pro Tour, and I think I've definitely improved from, you know, the drafts that I've done since I've returned. And I've also actually had the chance to do a few Team Sealeds. I did a couple of Team Sealeds with Tom, and then I also built one by myself on stream while Magic Online was in its downtime. So feeling pretty good. You know, I'm actually glad that I was able to do a couple of these practice sealeds because it actually allows me to see just kind of what we should be looking for when we, you know, build. So aside from that, you know, I think the most important thing is just making sure you're aware of what all the cards are. And I think both my teammates are, and they're very, very good. It's, you know, we're trying to come up with good team names for this. And Hain has already suggested, you know, Overwhelming Intellect and Paul and Tom. There's also the Pro Tour Champs and Paul, among a bunch of other ridiculous names. But yeah, we haven't really come up with one yet, but maybe we can come up with something clever on the trip. But really, really excited to be able to play with these guys. Should be a lot of fun. Team tournament's always great. It's probably one of the few reasons why I would actually go to an East Coast GP at this point. Okay, I am at the airport, headed off to Detroit. Teaming up with Tom and Alex. Got a long trip ahead of me. It's like my flight's at 11, but I have a layover in Chicago. When I show up in Detroit at like 9:15 or something. So it's gonna be a long trip, but it's okay. You know, like I said before, I don't really want to do too much traveling to the East Coast just because it usually takes up a whole day. But it's a Team Grand Prix, and I think, you know, if you have a collection of good players, Team Grand Prix are the, you know, the highest EV Grand Prix, I guess, if you're chasing pro points. So, so yeah, and obviously I'm very happy with my teammates, so it should be a blast. So just arrived in Detroit, but I thought Alex would be checked in, but he's currently having dinner, and the room is not under my name. It's under, I believe, Tom and Alex. But anyways, I'm hungry, so heading on over. Feel slightly unsafe walking the streets of Detroit later at night, but only live once, right? So I'm
bunch of guys for the Grand Prix here. Everybody already had their food, but everybody decided to get dessert. So, you know, so I don't want to make people wait for me. I also got dessert, so we all got chocolate lava cakes here. How is it, Mr. Hain, teammate?
A+, A+.
Hain's had a lot of good suggestions for our team name. What was the other one? The Pro Tour Champs and Paul?
Yeah,
something like that? Yeah, yeah.
And, the Platinums of Days Gone By and Alex. You know?
Yeah. A lot of great ones, but should be good here. You excited for this GP?
Yeah.
Waiting on Tom, who knows? He might not even show up.
Yeah, I mean, he might not, but I think our record will be the same either way.
Yeah, that is reasonable.
9-0-1.
Yeah, yeah. We can also probably just pick up a random third.
Yeah.
We can pick up Kenji maybe. Just be like, hey, just Kenji, don't do coverage.
No coverage, come with us. He's the vest is off. You
know? Yeah, yeah. Double up on the Cheons.
Right.
All right.
Then we get a sweet team name. It'd be just like two Cheons and a platinum level pro.
That doesn't even have a good ring to it.
Two Cheons and a Pro Tour champion.
All right. It's the morning of Grand Prix Detroit. Feeling good. We get 30 minutes of additional sleep thanks to Mr. Alex Hain here, Platinum Pro.
What about Tom Martella?
Tom Martella is just barely got gold by the skin of his teeth. So, we get a nice 30 minute extra sleep and also pre-registered decks. But that allows us to go to Starbucks. Hanging out with two-thirds of the...
Two-thirds?
Two-thirds of Grand Prix Nashville champion.
That's true.
You were not there.
And Grand Prix Nashville flavor text champion.
But that is the flavor text champion. We were actually just talking about the demon... For those of you guys watching, who is the demon that made a pact with Liliana?
A demonic pact.
Yeah. With Liliana.
Can you name all the demons?
If you can name all the demons... Wow, I will give you 10 bronze sables for Magic Online. I don't know, once the Chlog goes up.
Right after this.
Right. And the answer is no. No. Answer the comments, guys. Answer the comments.
Yeah.
Stars. a new team emerges here, and the more competition. We have PV, Jesse, and Player of the Year, Mr. Mike Siggers. It looks like after winning Player of the Year, he got some. Some fresh new fancy shoes. Look at those things. Oh no! Yeah, hey, look, we have a narrative here, and you're just quashing it.
To show the blood on my ankle.
Yeah. Congratulations on your beautiful twin girls.
Thank you very much.
Yeah. Are you excited to be a daddy?
I am. I'm excited to get home and see them.
Yeah. Take care of them and many sleepless nights.
Oh yeah.
In the future, many many sleepless nights.
Yeah.
And then wait till they turn two. Let's put it this way.
I enjoyed the fact I got to sleep while I was here.
Oh my God, Kyle, just yesterday, went to the daycare. Apparently got multiple timeouts because now he's no longer the smallest baby. So he was just walking around shoving the other babies.
He got
multiple timeouts, and I'm just like, he's two, it's just one of those things. Oh God.
Well, it's from the spirit of competition that his dad puts in him, He's like, he needs to keep up his rank of number one Cheon.
Yeah.
He has to push everybody around and let them know.
Just, our third teammate just leaving us, just hanging out early, but Wow, that was beautiful. That was nice. The camaraderie. What up, Josh?
What's going on, buddy?
Looking fresh.
Thank you.
I'll give you a handshake here. See how official that was?
Yeah.
It was nice. That's right. Nice haircut. It's all clean now.
Semi-finalist.
Well, yeah. Don't come on.
Come on, bro. Don't take this from me.
Yeah.
You've taken everything. Yeah.
You take this. I have nothing.
How's life finalist? Good.
Where are your teammates?
They're inside.
Rap Dog and Webster. Yeah. The two Chos, Ocho and Josh Cho. And Rap Daddy.
Rap Cho.
It's Rap Dog. Rap Daddy is Deathmiss Raptor.
Rap Daddy is Deathmiss Raptor.
That's what happened.
At the Pro Tour there were two Joshes on our team, so that didn't work. So we kept normally we call him Raptor, but we kept, every single deck we tested with had Deathmiss Raptor in it. So he's just like, just stop saying that because he keeps turning his head. So like, well, what do you want us to call you? He's like, call me Rap Dog.
No, no, that was Shahar's.
Oh, is this Shahar?
Rap Dog Millionaire.
Yeah, yeah.
It was Shahar.
Rap knows better. You can't give yourself a nickname.
You cannot give yourself a
nickname. Shahar.
Shahar keeps trying himself a nickname.
We're like, this is Rap Daddy. And he's Rap Dog or Little B. That Shahar tried to get Little B, like, for Little Bro.
Little B? Like, that doesn't even make any sense.
Shahar cannot bestow that nickname on anyone.
And so the little
All right, time to find our seats. This is the venue here, Grand Prix Detroit. Holy wow, this place is huge. Much larger than the venue for San Diego, it feels. But I think there's probably going to be more people here because it's in the East Coast. We have my teammates here. I got to go say hi to them, obviously.
Hey, I'll be right back.
I gotta say hi to my team. Look at all the people here getting ready to register their decks. And my former teammates here. How's it going, fellas?
How are the chlog?
The chlog.
What's a chlog?
What's a chlog, really, Luis? Where's Ben? Where's Ben? Yeah. PBO about to take it down. Feels weird. Wow. Hustle and bustle, round one. Where's my seat? 733, gotta find it.
So we need to find D.
What do we have here? We have 450. Oh my god. There's a lot of people. I guess I have time to do this.
I'm looking
for a thing. So I think we're pretty happy with our decks. They're very solid. We took the full amount of time. We were quickly trying to register our decks, but I think overall we're pretty happy with the end result. Looking for our seats round one, so should be good battles. Well, managed to win my first round. Well, if I do have a skill, it's picking teammates. I lost my match, drew a lot of lands, but Hain took it down. Crushed and
Paul gave me the worst deck.
Okay. Hain's got
my deck's insane.
Hain's got like, you know, two of the 10 best rares in the set. I think. It's pretty sweet. But anyways, now I'm going to the bathroom. It's actually upstairs, it's really weird.
Yeah.
So I want to let you guys know, you know, this is probably the most expensive Burst Lightning ever. Alex Hain just purchased the Burst Lightning that Pascal Maynard passed in Grand Prix Vegas.
That also defeated him,
which has a very high chance that it actually cost him the pro point needed to pass Alex Hain for a world championship.
This Burst Lightning got me to worlds.
So for sick rubbins, Hain offered $50 for this Burst Lightning, and he's going to give it to Pascal as a present.
What a good friend. I know the guy who got the foil goif, so I'm going to try and get a picture of them together again.
Reunited,
and it feels so good.
The most legendary Burst Lightning in all of Magic. Wow. Standard Super League superstar Josh Utter Layton in the Brewers bracket with Josh Cho and Ocho.
He's deep in the tank.
The dream team.
Look at that Stone Cold Killer.
I know. It's like we're doing commentary.
He's rearranging his lines. He's probably thinking about casting a spell or not casting a spell.
Wow, yeah. Definitely in the zone.
The opposing team seems to be deep in conference. How do we ever possibly beat this mastermind, this titan of the game?
I'm not sure if you're allowed to stand. That's all. So I was actually able to win my match this time around. So currently 2-0. Hain and Tom already also won their matches. So 2-0 today. Tom's keeping a track of how many times I lose my match and they win. And currently the carry the Cheon count is at 1. But hopefully, you know, I'm able to also pull off my wins. But Luis and Efro's team also 2-0. So we gotta always keep track to see just the overall record of the PBO. But like I said, I like our deck. One more thing,
I was cleaning up after my match, and I was just sitting around, and then Cedric just comes up to me out of nowhere, Cedric Phillips, and he's like, Paul, let me borrow a Sharpie. I got, you know, somebody's got, he's got to sign something. I'm like, of all the people here, you just come up to me and ask for a Sharpie? I mean, I had one, but still, it's pretty ridiculous. Just won our feature match. Played against Matthias Hunt's team. We won pretty quickly, so I'm feeling really good. I think our deck's actually pretty strong. So we're 3-0 currently. I know for a fact that Luis is standing behind me trying to troll me.
Yeah.
I knew you could see it.
I saw you like slow. You were like slowly lurking. Like, oh yeah. But how's your team? How's your team doing?
We're 3-0. I went 2-1, I guess. Now, it doesn't really matter individual records, but it's just interesting.
Everybody keeps track. What about the others?
Ben's 2-1, he feels 3-0.
Okay, so that's good sequencing. Good sequencing. All right. Well, best of luck.
I can't believe you guys broke up the dream team.
That was all Paul.
Brace for sudden impact.
Broke up the dream team. I can't believe it.
It's okay. We'll play again together for sure. This is just,
Wait. My hand's kind of shaking right now. We just won a super, super tight match. We all were down a game. Martell ended up losing. I won game three. And then Hayne won on turn three of turns. Turn three of turns in an insanely tight game where basically we were at one life and we cast two unholy hungers to go to three, then to five, and then back down to one. So it was really, really intense. But Hayne carrying the match. How does that one feel?
That one was a tight one.
That one's nice. Yes. I got a Chlog. Did you guys win? Yeah, nice. All right.
We played Williams.
I mean, you got Siggy on your team, so. Yeah, exactly. Up top, 5-0. Let's keep it going. All right, feeling pumped. 6-0, just won our match. Hayne is a master, undefeated, but you know, I think me and Martell have only dropped a match as well, so it's been going pretty well. There's only four other undefeated players, and so we're either going to be playing one of the four undefeated players in our bracket, or the X1 team. So that's five teams, and Luis's team, who's also in the same bracket as us, Luis Efra and Ben Stark, are also 6-0. So we actually have a 20% shot to play against them, and I'm getting photobombed. Oh my god. But I'm feeling good. I really like our decks, and my teammates are great, so they make very few mistakes, and their decks are also above average, so everything lining up well, so let's keep it up. Obviously this is happening. We're currently 6-0 and playing the rest of my teammates from the last Grand Prix. I am playing pro.
We don't know why you laugh. That's all I'm saying.
This is what happens when you ditch us.
You guys are unreal. This is ridiculous. How likely is that? This is...
Yeah.
Hey, what if this is not a feature match, though?
Oh, this is your fault for being 6-0. You knew we were going to be here.
Yeah. Oh my god, this is insane. All right. So here it is. Okay. Time to battle. Apparently they... Because this is completely random, Fro and Ben switch seats because apparently Ben is like 6-0 against Martell.
We didn't switch seats. We were deciding who's A and C, and they were like, well, it doesn't matter. And I just went and I could see on the website what seats you guys were in. I'm like, I'll put this.
All right, time to battle. Yeah. It would have been so nice for us to win that match, but it hurts. You know, the thing with teams is, obviously we lost, but the thing with teams is, it feels so much better when you win as a team, but it also, it's crushing when you lose. We got to bounce back and win two matches, the next two matches. We're 6-1. What a great story, right? We're both 6-0, we played the feature match, so.
But you beat Fro, though.
I did beat Fro, so.
You got your revenge. Ultimately, just like most revenge, ultimately meaningless.
Well, yeah, we had a good game two. Game one, he just kept the two lander, didn't draw third lands. Anyways, we ended up falling short. Not feeling great right now, but like I said, we still have a good record. So just try to win out the last two rounds and then do well tomorrow. All right, So managed to bounce back after losing to the Pork Ben Oath, or Mashi calls it the Pork Bun Oath Breakers. But yeah, we managed to bounce back and pick up a win. It was actually pretty close. And won the third game. And we're 7-1, locked for day two. We got one more match to play. And it's crazy. I mean, this is how it always is for team tournaments, but you know, the cream really does rise to the top when you lower the variance. You have all the best players playing on the same team. I mean, the Peach Garden Oath, Huey's team, 8-0. Mike Sigrist's team of Siggy, Paulo, Jesse Hampton, 8-0. You know, Siggy just doesn't lose right now. And Ifro, Luis, and Ben Scarf, also 8-0. And a lot of other good players are 7-1. So, you know, still in pretty good position. If we can finish off next round with an 8-1, oh my god. Now I just have to, I don't even have words. But if we can finish off today's strong 8-1, go 4-1 for a potential top 4 tomorrow, that would be good. But just happy that I'm day 2 with a couple of guys who respect a lot and good friends. It's really important for team tournaments to make sure you get along with the guys that you play with. All right, so after a loss to Ifro's team, they are actually 9-0, so good for our tie breaks. And we managed to win the other two rounds, and we are 8-1. We had some really, really sweet matches where it came down to Hain because he's on blue belt. I don't know what he's doing. He's jumping for joy, but it feels good.
It does. Tight ones. Paul won more matches than everybody else expected him to win, except for me, I believe.
Yeah. And it looked really bad because Tom was down in game. I lost when Chris Anderson mulliganed to 4.
I was at one life.
It wasn't even close. He crushed me.
With my opponent on black red at 20 life with two power creatures in play and me with also 2 power. That's just all.
Yeah, your match against that, every game was insane.
Yeah, all 3 games.
Yeah. Whew. Especially all right. So now we're about to head off to a celebratory dinner. Feels good.
Well, we can't quite celebrate yet. We still have more work to do tomorrow.
No, yeah, that's true. We gotta replicate it. I'll take a 4-1 tomorrow. Yeah.
I'd even take 3-1-1.
Yeah. I mean, we'll just 5-0.
Yeah, I'm happy with that.
Yeah. But there's a...
Or 4-0-1.
Yeah, a lot of great teams making day 2. I mean, in the 8-0 table in the feature match, it was Mike Sigrist's team versus... the Peach Garden Oath.
Yeah.
So they're definitely going to be in our bracket too. So it should be fun, very competitive. But,
it seems like the Platinums are rising to the top.
Yeah, the cream definitely rises to the top for those. But looking forward to tomorrow and battling against the best. All right, day 2 of the Grand Prix starting. How you feeling, Mr. Hain?
Awake. Barely.
That's good. Tom's just not here because...
Well, we got him a coffee.
We got him a coffee and food. He asked for both. Must be nice to be able to sleep extra. And then also just like have his friends just get him food. Unreal. But day 2 is about to start. It's 8:56. And feeling fresh.
Looking fresh.
Well, I had to make sure. That's why I had to go in first, you know.
When you're on camera, you know, just you need to put that extra.
That's right.
He took 35 minutes looking like this.
Anyways.
Yeah, tournament's about to start. I think there's a big group of people over there looking at seedings, and we're gonna head on over. We're currently 8-1 and ranked 3rd, right, in tiebreaks?
I think tiebreakers reset, so we're first.
But our tiebreaks are so good. But
it is actually insane in terms of like all the teams were 8-1 and 9-0. Like, they're all just amazing teams. Like, if you were to choose like 5 teams to be in the top of the standings, they're actually there. So it's gonna be hard fought battles. Hoping to open a really strong pool because I think, you know, outside of that, in terms of the skill gap between a lot of the teams that we're playing against, it's going to be really, really close. So we lost in a pretty horrific fashion. We lost the first round. Our decks aren't great, and I was not able to play a game of Magic. Games 1, 2, and 3. There were no games of Magic where I actually played in my match. He multiplied game 1, and I was discarding game 2. And then game 3,
we just got all completely crushed.
Yeah. And Hain's got a sweet deck, so hopefully we can rattle off some wins in a row. But There's a nice little feature match here. I mean, can you draw it up any better here? We have the Peach Garden Oath against the Pork Ben Oath. And it looked like Luis was victorious. So 10-0? Jeez. I wish I was on this team.
Fair enough. Our record would not be very good.
That Ben is 10-0?
Yeah, I've lost.
Is Ben good?
Good job, Luis. That looked like a pretty tight match.
Yeah, it was. He hasn't gotten made as pretty.
How does it feel to be 10-0?
He's picked a lot of commanders.
The same as being 0-3.
This is like, this just, yeah.
All right. Say we're out.
It's actually really good because I have to change my flight probably. So then I have to get like a hotel.
You're actually complaining about top fouring the GP?
I'm not going to get that much sleep tomorrow. Like,
unreal. Are your decks good?
We're still many rounds to go.
Your decks aren't great? Our decks are not great either.
Okay, our decks are like a little bit worse than our day two decks at San Jose.
Fine.
Yeah.
A little below average.
Right.
Being
same. Oh man. And Shahar, Brock, battling. Not exactly sure. Very, very disappointed. But you know, we're still alive. We have two losses, so we have to get a little bit lucky and rattle off three, maybe four in a row. So Ben is undefeated on the team, and it looks like they just won their match. They got paired up. They're the only undefeated player, and yeah, they are 11-0. But we also managed to put one on the board. We got three more rounds to go, and hope we can crush those.
Hopefully, we can get some more draws like in those games.
Yeah. Wasn't looking good as well because me and Tom were down a game. And then I played Manigord or Hydra against Green White, and he just didn't have removal. It's just turn three both games. So. Hopefully,
do you think a Green White that you just board in like Centipede just because Suppression Bond's like the only way they can ever beat that?
I considered it. I mean, I thought I had my bounce, but bouncing it is not that great. But I considered it because he had a Heart of Beast. But I just, I don't know, I just said against it because I thought like the bounce is good enough against its suppression bonus. I don't know.
That's reasonable.
Yeah. The Caterpillar could have been okay. But yeah.
I might have boarded in one.
Yeah, that's something to consider. 11-0. 11-0. How does we did win. We did win.
So you guys would be singing if they lost. There would be no chlogs.
There would be. I chlogged the last one I lost. I wouldn't be singing.
Classic
Sly.
I don't even get the
Sly.
Your fans want to know, what is it like to be so good at Magic?
I haven't won a game
in Yeah, give it to Ben.
I played pretty well last
match. Did you win? Hyxus?
If I lose, we're pretty bad.
Okay.
My deck is just the best. I won in round 9. The last round I won before that was 5. It's now round 12.
I think Tom won round 5. And
I've won 5 in 2.
All right. Well.
Yeah, I didn't.
Like Alex said, he did make his backpack a little lighter today, because of all the.
I made it heavier.
Oh, you made it heavier.
To practice.
Oh, to practice. That makes sense.
Gotta work out those muscles.
That's true. Yeah. On the bright side, Tom's at least like working out, so he's a little lighter. But you know, we'll still have to do some heavy lifting.
Well, the thing is, after that meal last night,
oh
we're all
my
pretty
god,
heavy.
Yeah, we are all pretty heavy. That is true. Siggy, record, one loss. Wow.
How about you?
Masters, 2. Good luck, fellas. Oh man, we've had some close ones. Round 4 is done, or round I guess 13. And we've managed to rattle off 3 in a row. So we are 3-1 on the day, and we're currently sitting at 13. I'm doing math in my head. 11-2. So we're currently 11-2, and we have one more round to go. And there's a lot of X2s. It's a huge, huge tournament. And yeah, I don't think we can get conceded to. There's a very good chance we just play Luis's team again next round, which would just be insane. But I think, even if we win, we might not make it, but it is essentially our win and end next round. We're 3-1, and if we win, we get there. If not, finish X3. So, you know, at least we know that we're gonna probably finish with some cash in our pockets and 3 pro points. So that's always just a good feeling, but, you know, This is it. One more round. And then hopefully two more rounds. So Ben Stark, their team just lost this round. So it's actually absurd because tie breaks reset for day two because this GP was so big that they started out 12-0. And because their breaks aren't necessarily good enough, they can actually miss out if they lose and the breakers don't hold up. If there's like six, there could be potentially six X2s. And Ben spent 20 minutes figuring out, and these are gonna be the matchup for next round. X1 versus X2, X1 versus X2, X2 versus X2, and X2 versus X3. So, what does that mean? The two X1s lose, that means we have four X2s there, an X2 between the X2, X2 bracket, and then if this X2 wins, we can have potentially...
Nobody cares about that, Paul. What they care about is that on your stream, you called that you're gonna be the GP Detroit champion. Now if we win the next three matches, we will be, all right?
All right.
That's what matters.
Anyways, yes, what we have to do is win. We have to win, and but at least it's a good feeling that we do have those 3-4 points locked up early on in the season. So let's do it.
Yep.
Up top.
Ow!
At X and two, we are battling against the Peach Garden Note. So the end game boss, win it in, get to play against the Triple Platinum team, the world's best, the Pantheon. We get to battle. Good luck, fellas. Let's play.
Fine, this is really difficult.
We lost in the feature match. Hain won his match, and me and Martel lost in three, and I lost in two. And it sucks. But it was a good run, you know. I think we played pretty well for most of the tournament. We were fortunate to have good decks day one, and I think going 3-2 with the pool that we had, I mean, that's about average, I think. It's not like our decks were insane or anything. So, you know, it's tough, because that, you know, just so much was on the line. And
game one just got pulled.
We just finished
X3. Magic, you know, you play your heart out, and the cards fall with you.
I mean, yeah, we lost to a great team.
We lost a great team, great players. You know, yeah.
And I'm now like 0-5 against Reed, dude.
That's
no, no. This is the chlog of sadness.
We gave ourselves as many possible outs to win. Like,
yeah. So anyways,
we had good fun.
Picked up 3 points.
No,
this is what
yeah.
This is what
happened.
Good luck, Shahar.
Thank
you. Did you tie it? Yeah, they got 2-2.
Oh, wow. Lucky Shahar. So, yeah, it is what it is. That was GP Detroit. You know, did a lot of preparation for it. We finished X3. And, you know, once again, 3 pro points. That's one less Grand Prix I have to go to. There's 6 finishes. And, you know, I really want to lock up those points as early as possible so I don't have to go to any more in the future because I want to spend more time with my family. But anyways, it was a blast.
Family, man.
Yeah, it's all about the family.
So close.
At least I can catch my flight home. And next tournament for me is going to be the World Magic Cup qualifier. It's going to be in 3 weeks. But anyways, it was a good run. It was a good run, but ultimately fell a little bit short. And look at this collection of masters in the top four. I think every team has a channel fireball. Everybody's part of channel fireball, or most of them. It's pretty great. Look at that. That is the top four. Chlog. Hey. Wow. That is great. We lost in Peach Garden Oath, so, you know, I consider most of these guys my friends, and best of luck to all of them. You know, despite finishing X3, the team I'm rooting for more is still Luis's team. Really hope they take it down, Luis Ifro and Venture. The team that I'm rooting for, so best of luck, guys. But everybody else, too, like I said, they're all my friends. They're all part of Team China Fireball, so it's pretty awesome to see just, you know, the really good teams actually have success. I mean, look at this. Like, if you were to choose, you know, the top 10 teams in the room, all four of those teams would have been part of that list, and they all made it, which is why team tournaments are great. You know, the best of the best, you're lowering the variance because all the good players, you know, all the 10% edge that they have against their opponents gets you further and further into the tournament. So, you know, you can win 2-1, and still get there. And that's great. And like I said before, you know, when you win as a team, it's amazing, especially when you win 2-1. When you lose as a team, it's crushing. Gonna go have some dinner, and I really can't wait to go see my family. Finished in 11th place, and the grind continues. Alright, taking off, saying goodbye. 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 Can't stay. I want to watch the rest of Luis's match, but I gotta go catch a flight. It was good battling with you, Mr. Hain. One more up top. Good luck at Worlds.
Thank you.
And I will see you at the next Pro Tour.
Yeah, I mean, we'll talk online about
Everything. Everything.
Yes.
All right, man. Have a good one.
Bye.
Later.
Good luck with the
Chlog. For sure. So I'm at the Dallas-Fort Worth Airport on my way back home. Can't wait to see my family. But turn on my phone and it looks like the team of Matt Nass, Sam Pardee, and Jacob Wilson managed to take out Grand Prix Detroit. So congratulations to that team. It's so insane. Jacob Wilson contributed to one match win the entire tournament, and they won. So Sam Pardee and Matt Nass putting on their carry pants, and they just won. They won a team Grand Prix last year too. They didn't have Sam. It was actually I'm trying to remember who it was. It was Matt Nass, Jacob Wilson, and why can't I remember? It was Matt Nass, Jacob Wilson, and Jesse Hampton who took it down. And you know, the original squad of Matt Nass, Sam Pardee, and Jacob Wilson was able to take it down. So once again, big congratulations to them. This top four was insane. If you were to handpick 10 teams for the tournament, four of those teams made the top four, basically. They, you know, all these guys are amazing players. It's pretty insane that all four teams had somebody wearing a Channel Fireball shirt. That's kind of cool. I believe at least, yes, Channel Fireball shirt. And Luis and Ifro and Ben Stark, they made it to the finals. I need to watch the coverage for the top four match, but you know, I'm sure a lot of the games, you know, were very intense and high level magic. It's basically like playing in the Pro Tour, right? Like all these guys are professional level players, and all four teams made top four, so that's pretty insane. As for me, what are my plans for the future? Well, I do actually have some time off. The last 3 weeks has been very, very taxing. I played, you know, the Pro Tour, followed by San Diego, and then this Grand Prix, but I have 3 weeks off. So, you know, I know you guys got back-to-back-to-back weeks of chlogging, but you know, no magic tournaments for me until the World Magic Cup qualifier, which is in 3 weeks, followed by Grand Prix Oklahoma. And I haven't booked for it yet, but I'm pretty sure I'm going to be going to Grand Prix Oklahoma. So, you know, once again, I feel very, very happy with the way I played this weekend, and I'm excited. I'm excited for kind of my, you know, once, you know, having opportunities to do well at the Pro Tour for this season. And I just can't wait for Milwaukee, and I'm just gonna do everything that I can to prepare for that tournament. And it starts now. It's not just the week before the Pro Tour. You just gotta make sure you continue to improve and get your game to the level to compete with the best. So thanks everybody, and I guess I'll see you guys for the World Magic Cup qualifier.